My name is Steven Katz. I'm a professor of medicine and health management and policy at the University of Michigan, and I help lead a cancer research team called the Cancer Surveillance Outcomes Research Team, or CanSORT. I was born and raised in Chicago. My father never graduated from high school. He was a very smart man. My mother was valedictorian of her high school, but her parents couldn't afford for her to go to the university, and she did not. I came from very smart parents and very enabling parents, but I was the first generation to achieve a professional job and one of the first doctor in my extended family, and I'm the only professor in my extended family. So it was a journey that I went on my own, but I have to say, when you turn to your parents and say you want to be a doctor, they're kind of happy about that. And so I went out west to the college at the University of California, Santa Barbara, with a strong interest in being a marine biologist. Shortly after college, I decided not to go directly to any sort of post-university program, and instead wanted to work. I wound up at a clinic, La Casa de la Raza, which is a low-income clinic in East Santa Barbara, and there I had a heck of an education about how people live, how they experience, how they think about their health, and how I could help with that with regard to the kind of work that I was doing. I went to medical school in San Francisco. I was a medical student during the AIDS explosion, the AIDS epidemic. Those were really, really important formative years that reinforced how important a public health-oriented career in medicine could be. So let me give you an example of what we do. We study patients with breast cancer, and patients with breast cancer are increasingly confronted with an unbelievable amount of information, different testing, and different results of the testing, and they're really left at wit's end. They're really left with a sense of, how do I proceed? How do I make the choices I need to make to get the treatment that I need to do better? At the same time, on the other side of the exam table are doctors who are trying to explain increasingly more complicated information. So there's an enormous need to understand what patients know about their treatment, what patients think about the treatment process and decision making, and we study that. So let me give you an example. We're doing a study of 5,000 women with breast cancer in the state of Georgia and the state of California. We're able, through the state health departments of both regions, to contact patients shortly after diagnosis and send them a packet that, when they open it up, has a letter from me inviting them to be in the research, and a questionnaire to fill out about their experiences, about the receipt of treatment and tests, and about their appraisal and their opinions about what happened. We take that kind of information and we bring it together and we analyze it to inform doctors about how well they're doing. We have statisticians to move our science up a level. We have psychologists to help us with questions about decision making. We have clinicians, including surgeons, medical oncologists, radiation oncologists, and geneticists, helping us develop the topics that are most important to doctors and patients, how we should think about the treatments, how we should think about the tests. So what we've done is married the clinical sciences to the psychology and sociology sciences and statistics to create this team vision of science. Our research team meets Tuesday afternoon. I only wish that those of you who are out there listening to me could be in the room to see all the marvelous things that we're doing, the fights over the questions, the discussion over what method we're going to go at it, and do it from all these different angles. This keeps me young.